There's nothing more precious than the birth of a child, but for many parents, a healthy baby sadly doesn't always result in a healthy mom after delivery. In fact, in contrast to the global trend, the rate of maternal mortality is rising in the United States. My next guest, Annie, and her husband, Tom, have two healthy sons, but after the birth of their children, Tom almost lost his wife to severe complications. Here's their story.
After I had my first child, I had a postpartum hemorrhage.
The more quickly that doctors and nurses were moving about, the more nervous I became. It had very quickly turned to fear.
Doctors were able to intervene and stop the bleeding.
Several weeks after our second child was born, Annie was rushed to the hospital.
I ended up having multiple surgeries. I was resuscitated during surgery when I lost too much blood. Oh my gosh, what just happened?
To not be able to help Annie made me feel very helpless.
I felt very much afraid that the kids depended on me, and if I wasn't around, that was scary.
Annie is an amazing mother, and she truly keeps our family together. We're still processing everything that's happened. It has brought us closer.
You can't imagine what motherhood is like. You never thought you could love somebody so much. I'd say that's so cliche, but it's all true. I really worried that I was gonna die.
Well, Annie and Tom are joining me along with our very good friend and chief patient officer of Pfizer, Dr. Frieda Lewis Hall. So thank you all for being here. Now, Annie, you had very serious complications after the birth of both of your sons, actually. Just how bad was it?
I had to have a surgery to remove some of the placenta that was still attached to my uterus.
Right.
3 years ago, when I had my second son, I ended up having to have 4 emergency surgeries, massive transfusions, resuscitation, and eventually a hysterectomy.
Wow, I'm so sorry to hear that. And Tom, this had to be a very difficult time for you as well.
You expect to have a baby and then go home and everybody's happy and healthy. And so it was difficult and scary.
Dr. Frieda, just how serious is this problem?
From 2000 to 2014, the maternal mortality rate in the United States has increased approximately 27%. An estimated 4 million women give birth in this country each year, and of those, approximately 700 will die from pregnancy or childbirth-related complications, and over 50,000 will have severe complications, as Annie did.
What would cause a woman to possibly die after giving birth?
So there are a number of factors that are included. Increases in maternal age and pre-existing chronic conditions. And studies show that 72% of deaths that are related to pregnancy in the U.S. are caused by severe bleeding, as in Annie's case, coronary or cardiovascular conditions or chronic diseases of the heart, infection, blood clots or high blood pressure during pregnancy, and mental health conditions. But also it's important to note that in the United States, there are 3 groups of women that have significantly higher risk of maternal mortality: African American women, women in lower income, and women in rural areas. And according to the CDC Foundation, African American mothers have 3 to 4 times the risk of maternal mortality than white women. Now, this is one of the worst racial disparities in women's health in this country.
Wow. Now, Tom, as a father and husband who's been through this twice, what's your advice to men who find themselves in this same place?
I think to men and to women, I would say you're not alone. And also to highlight the fact that oftentimes new mothers need just as much support as their new babies.
Dr. Frieda, what's the best way for women and men to prepare for potential problems after birth and not just be caught completely unaware?
Dads and moms should educate themselves about potential risks and warning signs of pre and post pregnancy and childbirth complications. Also, ladies, make sure that you have a healthcare team that you're really comfortable with discussing both risks and potential complications, and don't be afraid to ask questions. And also, given the importance of medical history, make sure to share your medical history so that the provider has a full picture.
And I want to add, to make sure that you have a strong emotional support team of family and close friends. That's important, right? And a great place to start educating yourself on this important subject is at gethealthystayhealthy.com. Robin and I both love this website. We go to it all the time. They have a pregnancy checklist there that you can refer to, as well as a wealth of other health information.
And of course, while you're there, you can sign up for our monthly newsletter.
I want to thank all of my guests today. Thank you for bringing this. I had no idea that this was on the increase in the United States compared to other countries. We need to be aware of this.
So, and do something about it.
Thanks for being here.